Dear students, very pleasant good morning to all of you. Today we are going to discuss about the effects of the air pollution, as some of the effects or consequences we already discussed in the previous lectures. Today we will try to discuss some more remaining impacts of the air pollution, and the impacts today we are going to discuss is global warming. All you must have heard about the global warming, or we may say global warming. Global warming, as it has become a global warning system for the whole world, as tremendous increase of temperature is showing a deleterious impacts on the plants, animals, microorganism, and so many other materials and properties. So what actually global warming is? If we discuss about the global warming, we know the earth is surrounded by an envelope of gases which we call as atmosphere, and in the atmosphere we have a constituent gas which we call as carbon dioxide. Carbon dioxide itself is actually a basic constituent of the atmosphere, and the presence of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is vital for the survival of living organism, as it has become a source of entrapment of heat radiation, which is necessary for maintaining the ambient temperature of the earth. So the presence of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is necessary for survival of every living organism, including plants, animals, and other microorganisms. And the concentration of or amount of carbon dioxide in our atmosphere is 0.03% by volume. It must be there. So what is the function of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere is, the incoming shortwave radiation is easily trapped, is easily penetrated through the atmosphere, and when it reaches on the surface of the earth, it gets reflected back in the form of long wave radiations, or we say these are heat radiation, or we say IR radiation, infrared radiations, or terrestrial radiations, or outgoing radiations. And these radiations, as the name indicates, heat radiation, having the capability of heating our ambient atmosphere, but it must be trapped within the atmosphere, it must be absorbed within the atmosphere, and the absorption of such heating radiations are caused by the presence of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere. This was the brief function I discussed here about the carbon dioxide. This is the natural carbon dioxide which performs this function, and already told you this is necessary for survival of every living organism on the surface of the earth. But what happens if the same carbon dioxide, by anthropogenic activities, we have different anthropogenic activities of releasing carbon dioxide, anthropogenic activities, like we are releasing carbon dioxide from industries, we are releasing it from factories, we are releasing it from automobiles, we are releasing it from domestic source, and we are releasing it from incineration, and we are releasing it from so many other sources, be it burning of deforestation, etc. So increase of carbon dioxide increases the entrapment of heat radiation in the atmosphere. What does it mean? It means if we are increasing the amount of carbon dioxide by different means, we are increasing the capability of entrapment of long wave radiation or heat radiation in the atmosphere. As a result, what happens? the carbon, increase in carbon dioxide amount in the atmosphere increases the absorption of heating effect on the atmosphere. As a result, the earth is experiencing an increased temperature day by day. So what we call global warming, it means progressively increase in ambient temperature of our environment due to addition of excessive carbon dioxide in the atmosphere because of anthropogenic activities mentioned here, which results the increase of heating effect on the surface of the earth, which have a deleterious effect on properties, on materials, on climate, on rise of ocean level, glacial receding, and so many other effects in connection with the global carbon dioxide, or in turn the global warming results. So what we got a concept of global warming. Global warming is actually a global warning where we are experiencing the progressive increase in temperature because of addition of carbon dioxide and other gases, like we have nitrous oxide, we have chlorofluorocarbons, we have hydrochlorofluorocarbons, we have ozone, we have methane. These are the gases which significantly contributes to global warming. But out of these, almost 50% of the global warming is contributed by carbon dioxide. But if we see in terms of potential, the potential of greenhouse effect or enhanced greenhouse effect of the carbon dioxide is very less as compared to the nitrous oxide, hydrochlorofluorocarbon, ozone and methane and other greenhouse gases. But due to large amount of presence of carbon dioxide in the atmosphere contributes more global warming by carbon dioxide as compared to other gases. But in terms of potential of greenhouse gases, the carbon dioxide is having a low potential of global warming or heating effect. So this was one of the effect of air pollution, because we are releasing the pollutants of carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, chlorofluorocarbons, hydrochlorofluorocarbons, ozone, methane, etc. into our atmosphere, and these are actually adding in the atmosphere due to anthropogenic activities. So progressively what we are doing, we are increasing the global temperature of the earth, global ambient temperature of our atmosphere. As a result, the heating effect all over the globe results, which we call as global warming. More precisely, we can say progressively increase in temperature of the earth or the ambient atmosphere due to addition of greenhouse gases like carbon dioxide, nitrous oxide, chlorofluorocarbon, hydrochlorofluorocarbon, ozone, methane, etc. Simply call this global warming. Then we have ozone layer depletion. As already discussed in the previous lecture, we have a layer of atmospheres. The lowest layer we call a troposphere. Above troposphere, we have stratosphere. Means up to 16 kilometer from the surface of the earth, we are having troposphere, and above the troposphere, this is the stratosphere. In the stratosphere, the concentration of ozone or amount of ozone is very much, and in the very layer, at 25 kilometer, amount of O3 is very much higher, and the zone is known as ozonosphere. means the presence of O3 is very much high in this very layer. That's why we call these are ozonosphere. So what's the function of ozone actually? As the radiations radiate from sun containing ultraviolet radiation, as it reaches on the stratosphere, because of the presence of highest amount of O3 in the stratosphere, it never allows the UV radiation to reach on the surface of the earth, and it gets absorbed or reflected towards the upper atmosphere. But during the course of absorption, the heating effect results in the stratosphere. That's why attaining height, the temperature in the stratosphere increases. So what happens if the O3 gets depleted by any means? As we are adding so many ODS substances, ozone depleting substances. For example, so many ozone depleting substances we have. For example, chlorofluorocarbons we have, hydrochlorofluorocarbons we have freons, we have methyl bromide, and we have halons. These are some of the substances which are anthropogenically adding into the atmosphere, and these are collectively known as ODS, ozone depleting substances. And what happens when we add ODS or ozone depleting substance into our atmosphere? These reduces or breaks down the O3 into O2 and nascent oxygen. And either the oxygen itself or the nascent oxygen, it never having the capability of trapping the UV radiation. As a result, the UV radiation easily reaches on the surface of the earth and showing many deleterious impacts on the surface of the earth, including human beings, properties, ecological system as well. So what may be the impacts of these O3 on the surface of the earth? For example, if UV radiations are reaching on the surface of the earth, we have materials. For example, it is showing rubber brittleness, means cracks in rubber. It causes lung cancer among human beings, and it also have effects on plants like necrosis, chlorosis, means productivity of crop is going to decline because of the impacts on the crops or the plants. And similarly, it also results collapse of food chain, especially the microflora and fauna get severely damaged, and it also results collapse of aquatic food chain, because the phyto and zooplanktons are very sensitive to this UV radiation. Besides this, emphysema also results among the human being. Emphysema. So these are some of the deleterious or negative impacts of the UV radiation as reach on the surface of the earth. And why the UV radiation reach on the surface of the earth? Because of the depletion of the O3 in the atmosphere. And how O3 gets depleted in the atmosphere? Because of addition of ozone depleting substance we are adding day by day in the atmosphere for our own convenience. But in the long way, we are actually damaging ourselves, either our health or it may be a property, it may be a ecological system. So what we are supposed to do? We are supposed to minimize the use of such ODS substance as far as possible. Then we have effects on crop. As already discussed, we Chlorosis and necrosis are the impacts caused by the depletion of the ozone in the atmosphere, which results negative impacts like abscission, necrosis, chlorosis, wilting of leaves, epinasty, etc. These are the impacts which we can have as the UV radiation reach on the surface of the earth. So the impacts are also seen on the crops. Impacts on the flora fauna is already discussed. There are microflora and fauna existing on the surface of the earth and having a prominent role for maintaining the ecological system. But what happens is we deplete the ozone because of addition of ozone depleting substance on the surface of the earth. This gets damaged and deleterious effects are seen, and effects on materials and property is already discussed. Brittleness of rubber, shedding of paints, decoloration, and so many other impacts are seen easily. As we are supposed to discuss the ozone layer depletion in the next topic in detail, it was just a brief introduction about the ozone layer depletion. Hope you understand some of the impacts of the air pollution. Stay home, stay safe, best of luck.